Hello everybody, welcome to the Empressive channel. Ariana Grande dropped her new song called Seven Rings, and a lot of people were talking about it. Some people loved it, and some people criticized it. A lot of people were calling out Ariana Grande for actually stealing the song from several artists. One of them being Princess Nokia. Princess Nokia is an underground rapper who had a song called Mine. And her song Mine does sound very similar to Ariana Grande's song Seven Rings. Check it out. It's mine, I put it. 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 I want it.
About brown women and their hair? Sounds about white.
Ooh, child, Princess Nokia went there, didn't she? Well, she might have a case because the songs do sound pretty similar, but her song isn't the only song that Ariana Grande has been accused of swiping. Some people were saying Ariana Grande's song was somewhat inspired by 2 Chainz' song, Spend It.
It's mine, I spend it. It's mine, I spend it. It's mine, I spend it. It's mine.
Now, you just heard 2 Chainz' version, and you could argue that both Princess Nokia and Ariana Grande copied his version. Ariana Grande's song, Seven Rings, has also been compared to Soulja Boy's song, Pretty Boy Swag. And if you listen to the song, the flows are somewhat similar.
Everybody pay attention. This right here is mine.
So as you can hear, Ariana's song Seven Rings does sound similar to some other songs, but I guess out of all the songs, it does sound the most similar to Princess Nokia's song Mine. But if we're being completely honest, both Princess Nokia and Ariana Grande kind of bit from 2 Chainz. And I know some people are going to be in the comments like, no, they all stole from Big Draco, Soulja Boy. And I know Soulja Boy is going to be like this. Ariana? 2 Chainz?
That's my bar. He copied my whole fucking flow. Word for word, bar for bar.
Anyway, I do think that Ariana Grande's writers, Victoria Monet and Taylor Parks, might have been the ones who've been influenced by some other hip-hop tracks, and they gave this sound to Ariana. But, you know, it's kind of backfiring a little bit because Ariana is being accused of taking other people's songs. And not only that, people are kind of accusing her of appropriating the black culture. Me personally, I like Ariana. I'm actually a fan of hers. And I don't mind her dibbling and dabbling in other genres and trying to, you know, be more versatile, but it has to be done in a more organic way. Go from the south to the booth, make it all back in one loop. Give me the loot. Never mind, I got a juice. She's trying to follow the footsteps of Beyonce and Rihanna, but I don't know how I feel about it. Ariana, for the most part, is a pop artist and she appeals to a certain demographic. I think her venturing off into hip hop and trap and trying to do this whole sound is not the best direction. It doesn't really match her artistry and it comes off as very forced. But I understand that her label is trying to push her in a direction that can appeal to certain audiences because hip hop right now is the most listened to genre in music. So she's doing what is popular, but I think she has to be true to herself and not conform into an image that's not her. But that's just my whole thoughts on that. Anyway, tell me what you all think about this down below. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video if you care. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.